Excuse me, 1 minute.
Yeah.
Not here.
Sorry. No, cannot go.
Yeah, I'm ready.
Okay.
Sorry.
No. So yesterday we discussed about Hasti Amma, and today we are going to start some ASP.NET. So ASP.NET, if at all you want to develop any web applications, we can develop with the help of in two ways. One is called as a web by using web server or development server. By using web server or development server we can use. So how we can develop means? Web server and development. For web server, it's mandatory we must know, we must have IIS. So this is nothing but Internet Information Servers. And for development server, it is said to be where you can create the application in our local system. So this, if at all you want to create, so any application you create with the help of IIS, you want to run, so it's not, means suppose you are creating your application, your local system, but it, any other want to use, whatever the application you create with the help of ASP.NET, if any, you want to run your application by, on any other system, normally web application, whatever you create, websites, whatever you create, so generally it will be run on remote machines, servers. So means remote machine means servers. So whether you create in your systems or wherever you create, it will be run globally. So like yahoo.com, Gmail, so might be created by some other companies, but it will be run globally. So that is nothing but on remote machines, it will be run on globally. So for that purpose, we must need some web servers, IIS. If at all no sir, I want to run local limit, no need of IIS. So but the latest versions of Visual Studios from 2010, we are getting IIS will be installed with the help of Visual Studio only. Inbuilt IIS you are going to get, but still we are going to install IIS. How you are installing means? Go for control panel, as already I showed you, programs for turn Windows on or off. So Internet Information Services, select all these, check mark all these things, click on OK. FTP, web management tools, web services, Internet Information Services Hostable Web Core. Click on OK. Now, the simple application I'm going to run. So how you are creating the client, you are sending a request from the client, how we can create a request from the client to the server, we are going to do with the help of ASP.NET. File new. Website. So here I am selecting you are selecting file system, nothing but you are creating the application with the help of application server. It's a basically application server, it's not development server or application server, both are same. Application server, and wherever you want to create, select the desired location. ASP.NET empty website. Click on OK. So go for Solution Explorer, right click, we are adding a web form, click on OK. My client page, we are adding some HTML page, nothing but my client page. Similarly, right click, add a web form. Adding a server page. So simple message I'm writing here in the server page. Placing the form tag. Action nothing but the by using form. So I'm going to call some page nothing but my server page.aspx. So you'll see what is method, get method. As of now, what is get method, we won't know, we'll see later. So I'm placing a control call button. So for this purpose, we'll learn HTML. In server page.aspx also see, we had written some HTML tags. So this is called as a source page. Go for design. Even in the client page also HTML page. So this is a HTML page. You are placing a form tag. When I click on the submit button, it is calling the server page. It is invoking server page. When I have multiple pages, I want to start the client page, set as startup page. So here our aim is to how we are sending the request from the client to server page. Just control F5. So from the client, you are sending the request to call the invoke the server page, my server page invoke. So a simple way of calling from the client to the server page. So I'm making a little bit more enhancement, the same example. Placing some more controls. It's not necessary to give the value. So this is simple HTML page where I'm placing labels, text box, passwords and submit button. Now this is simple ASPX page. Press F7. Here I'm writing some logic. So for a given username, so what is the username we had given there? TXT uname. To display the message onto the web page, response.write like console.write line. Control F5 wherever you are. So when you have click on set as startup page, it starts request from starting page will be obviously see here. I have given the values, obviously it will take from. So why you are getting invalid login means I am using user get method. When you use the get method, you are going to get the values username equal to .NET and password. So your whatever the values you are giving, the credentials, username and password, everything you are able to see. So its get method is not secured. You can see each and every values. So if at all you want to hide the values, you are going to use the post method. So post method basically it's a hidden method which will secure the data. So we are not in the address bar, you are not able to see any usernames and passwords. It's a simple valid login. So this is how you are doing a simple. So this is the source, and if username and we are checking the logic in the master page, in the page, main page, server page. So this is the logic of that page. So we are writing all the logic in C# only. So from the client, you are sending the request and checking the logic in the server. So saying that whether the username exists or not, username and password is matching or not, like that we are doing. So it's a simple sending the request and getting the response from the server and displaying the output. You got me? So here in ASP.NET, generally we won't write that much logics, but very important thing is, so we have to know HTML tags and some ASP tags. So this is just see here, all these are ASP tags. All ASP tags, basically I hadn't sorted ASP tags here, I will show you. This is some C# logic. So a simple login application I'm creating. By default you are going to get as default.aspx. Observe here where I'm adding so many controls. ASP means server side controls, nothing but ASP controls. Label id equal to, by default the notation will be like this, LBL. So all the server side controls will be run at server. ASP controls are set to be run server side controls. And ASP controls will write, HTML controls will write. So in ASP we'll write text to display the message, whereas in HTML we'll write value. So almost both will have the name or ID to represent. So input type equal to button, so see the difference. Now click on this server side control. When you click on server side control, we are writing the logic script or logic for a ASP control in C#. To display the message, so a simple message I want to write, response dot write, it's a server side control. But when you go for HTML, so we are in the same control only. So to write the message, on click equal to, we are writing some event, we are writing, we are calling a function. So where we have to write this function means in some JavaScript. Text.javascript. Use the function. So this function I'm calling here and writing a simple message in JavaScript like response.write or console.write. Here we are having document.write. It's a client side control. To go for control of fine. So you are sending the request from the client to the server. So it's a server side controls. When you go for client side, immediately you are getting the request, because in the client side controls it won't send the request and get the response. It will render the information on the same web page. There is no means the here when you click on server side controls, the HTML, this control will send the request from the client and get the response. But when you go for HTML controls like input type HTML control, it will send the request, but it need not to send the response. You need not to send the request to the server for HTML controls. Directly it is displaying the output for us. So that's why you are getting very fastly the output. So for HTML controls, where you will write the logic means in JavaScript. For ASP controls, you will write the logic in C#. Okay. Madhumita?
Yeah. Okay.
Now. Thank you. So when you go for a web form, add a web form. Press F7. See here you are having some default event called page load. Like Windows application you are having mouse up, mouse down, form load like that. Here you are having for web pages will be there, web pages, page load. And select the page, press F4. You can see here you don't have other events. We don't have the symbol here for events. So how to get other events is, so only the way is we have to know that. So just I copy pasted, some other predefined events are there, like before page is initialized. So pre-init, before page is initialized, this event will rise fire for us, that is called pre-init. And one more event will be there, that is called as a a lot of noise is there. So preload, a lot of noise disturbance is there only. Okay, so preload, before page is loaded you are going to get execute. No, now it's clear. So before while the page is initialized, that is the page init event will fire, and before the page is loaded, page load event will fire. One more event. When the content of the controls will execute, page render. Rendering means whatever the content is there in the controls, like text box, buttons, labels, text box or combo box, whatever you having, any data is there, that will be displayed onto the web page. So we won't say it as a display, it is said to be rendering. So and the last one is said to be unload. So try to execute. So this unload event is like a destructor. So before you are closing the form, you are trying to use the fire the unload event, it won't work. So just comment this. See, all the events are firing. So depending on the requirement, we are going to use that. Now Gopher default SPX, this is called as a Gopher source, this is called as a paste directive. So specifying which language you want to use. So like I'm going to use the source code, so C# language, and this is called auto wire up. Auto event wire up means true. Like suppose I don't want to execute page events, any page events I don't want to execute, make it as false. If you are writing, if auto event wire up is false, any page events won't fire. See, it is executed, it executed, but we are unable to see any output because any page events are not fired. So try to make it true this event. Yes. Now so and the logic you are writing is default.aspx.cs. So all these are said to be page load events. So we cannot write like Windows application, we cannot select the events from properties window. We mandatory we have to write those events. Like Windows applications we are having controls, here also we are having controls, but we are going for some other defined controls, different controls we are going for. Like you might be seeing so many advertisements are rotating onto the on the web page, so that type, that control is said to be add rotator control. Go for standard controls, click on add rotator controls. Suppose wherever you want to place the control, in your desired location you want to move the control, go for tools, options, HTML designers, CSS styling, change position to absolute, change position absolute for controls. You can move the control to a desired location wherever you want. Add some HTML which had written already. Add existing item. So three web pages we have added. First, form demo formatting. Right click, similarly add some images. On the desktop I'm having three images. Now, add a new control core. Add new item. So which will be set to be XML file. So add info.xml, click on add. So this is basically, it's a predefined tags or the, we can create our own tags also. So image URL means to place an image. Which image you want to place? By clicking on the image, to which image you want to navigate. Impressions, which image you want to get more frequently. If you are not getting image, you are writing some alternate text. So how many ads are there? That many ads you can write. So we have added three images. Now go for default order SPX. Choose data source. Go for default order SPX. Select the control properties. Add info.xml. 1 second. So try to execute this. So you are getting the, click on this. So if you are not getting image, so click on this. Yeah, see here. To get more frequently the images you want to rotate. So go for source. Use the tag, meta tag, which will refresh the web page for every 2 seconds. Refresh. So impressions means which images you are getting more frequently. This is missing HTML. It's a simple add rotator control. So this is a predefined tags where you are using.
Okay.
So still all whatever we have using Windows application, some predefined controls, buttons, labels, text boxes, combo box, menu strip, everything will be there. Whatever we have used there, we can use here. So try out that those controls also. But the only thing is we can drag and drop. But the thing is, or if at all you want to write, you have to write in the form of scripting format, like this tags format you have to write.
Okay.
So tomorrow session I'm going to start some more controls. So many other controls are there for us, like data controls, validation controls, like that. So all those things we are going to discuss.
Okay.
Any queries?
No. Actually, this concept will be much better. The HTML and all these things.
Okay. Sure.
Okay then.
Yeah. Bye.
Bye. Have a good day.